Hello, my name is Brandon Kane. Welcome to the Crow's Nest, Mariners Central, as I'm now going to call it. Well, we got some great news today. Julio Rodriguez, the fantastic number two overall rated prospect in baseball, by Prospectus, is going to be called to the show. You're getting your call, young man. Getting the call. Come on up. It's that time. And this is exciting news for us Mariner fans. It draws to my mind certain parallels to a young kid coming up out of Cincinnati in 1989, much like Julio, only played a couple of years minor league ball. Had this dynamic energy to him, a smile that lit up the room. And I see the same thing in Julio. Similar sort of prodigious talent that you're looking at. I mean, Julio's not going to be necessarily the fielder that Kenny was. May not have the arm in the outfield that Kenny does, but he's got that pop in the bat. And he is absolutely raking the ball this spring. By far the best Mariners hitter. He earned this opportunity, earned this chance. And that's what makes this as exciting as anything else. Not only is it the right decision in my mind, because why not let these guys play at this point? Get them up there. Let them grow. Let them learn. You saw that with Kelnick last year. It took him a little while to kind of try to find himself a bit, but they will find themselves. Talent will rise to the occasion eventually. But as it is said in baseball, you've got to get these guys 500 at-bats before you're going to get to that spot where you're really getting the returns. And this just does everything to accelerate that process and more. It is going to be fun to watch this young bunch grow and learn how to win in this game. And potentially, again, as we get into the next couple of years, really get us on up into that next level of things of a potentially, I know I dare say it here, a World Series. We'll see. I'm not expecting it this year. This year's about growth. This year's about watching this talent develop by adding to the talent as well, because I know a lot of people are knocking DePoto right now for not making enough signings, for not spending enough money. But look, you didn't want to just have them spend money just to spend money. You wanted them to spend money because it was the right thing to do, because there was actually players out there that deserved to be picked up. Why not wait in the weeds? Why not wait low in those weeds for right around the trade deadline, when maybe you can then take on salary from a team that's looking to offload it for minimal cost at that point and get a much more talented player? And at that point, to put your allocated your monetary resources elsewhere, smarter, better, rather than overspending, let's say, $70 million to bring Chris Bryant here, who obviously really didn't want to come here. But this year, it's going to be about this young talent. It's going to be about watching Julio Rodriguez grow. I was there in 1989 getting to watch Griffey play, and he alone was worth the price of admission. And though he wasn't the superstar in that first year, he was still really good and still really fun. And when he started to grow into what he was and what he became, every night he was going to do something special. Didn't have to necessarily be at the plate, could have been on the base paths, could have been out there in the field, but he was going to do something special. And I'm getting the same kind of old-timey magic feeling with Julio Rodriguez. Let's see where this kid goes. Let's see where this season goes. But it's going to be fun to watch together. My name is Brandon. This is The Crow's Nest. Thank you. Please like. Please subscribe. And don't you guys forget, go M's.
You look comfortable in center field.
I am. Yeah? I am. If you had to play center field in a big stadium with an extra deck on it, you think you could handle that?
Yeah. Come on.
I think it's time, Julio. I think it's time. Bring on the J-Rod show. Okay? You good for that?
Yes.